I know that unfortunately it's not a new cosplay today because I'm going to be redoing part 2 of the Chucky cosplay. Reason being, although my injuries have healed now, as you can see the, well, the burn's still there, but it's healing. I had an allergic reaction to something. I just thought, I was a bit embarrassed actually when I read it, watched the video and thought, what the flip, this is horrendous. So this one, I'm not going to be using latex, although you could use latex, I'll put it on top at the end. Just because, so when blocking out my eyes, I did have an allergic reaction to one of the substances I was using. I was actually going to put foundation on, but I think that's not the best idea. So if you want to put foundation on, that's fine, but I've just decided I'd be worried about it mixing with the face paint or something. So what was I doing? Oh yeah. I'm going to start off, you can actually see where I did it before, still there, so that's made life easier. Right, so I'm going to do this video from my right eye, because it seems all the skin's been torn off his right eye, and it's actually pretty gruesome. So I'm actually going to try to think about it. I'm going to get him, might be helpful if I had a mirror in front of me, wouldn't it? I actually just realized I've given myself a black eye. But the reason that I was dragging out a wee bit is just because he's got like big torn bits up here, so I'm going to try and blacken them a bit more. So what I'm just going to do now is, before I do the stitches and all, I've noticed he actually has one on his mouth as well. I don't really want to put face paint in my mouth because I have swallowed it before. It tastes awful. So I'm just going to do it from the lip here and just put it down. But this one's very simple. You just need a much thinner brush. I don't know if this is the thinnest one I have. I'll maybe use this one for like the slightly bigger cuts and this one for the thinner cuts. But then you've got two options here. You can either follow, I mean, I've got a reference photo in front of me here, so I can copy it, which I intend to do. Or you could just make up your own pattern like I did in the last cosplay, because I must have been losing it. I'm actually just going to go grab some water because I noticed that helped the face paint go on a lot better. When I said get some water, I meant just dip my face paint brushes in it. Right, so I'm going to start off with doing the bigger cuts, and most of the big cuts are around this eye. I would say there's maybe the one on this side is quite big. It does go through the eyebrow. I'm going to try and avoid that if possible, because I've tried washing face paint down my eye around the past. It's a nightmare. And then the thinner ones, obviously, we're going to use the thin one. There's one here, it's quite thin. The one from going from here to, I think it's to there, is quite thin. And then obviously there's bits here that, I suppose you could say, redo's hair. You could make it cuts if you want. I might make it cuts actually. And then obviously we're going to use the staples around there. So yeah, just use this face paint, just I would say start from big to small. I'm just gonna make one here. I can't have this side bare, you know. I need something on this side. Right. This face paint was very easy to make. You literally just mixed red and black, and it got out this beautiful maroon color, like plummy maroon color, which looks wee bit like dried blood. So there you are. So he does have very slight red on this side, but I thought that would take it away from this side, which I'm just gonna touch up a little bit. But I'm going to talk to you while I'm doing it, so this video won't be sped up. But there you are. Very easy to do. I would say if you want to make it look a bit more bloody, you can add a bit more red. You'll notice a wee bit down my neck. That's because I noticed when I looked at it. Even though you can't see his neck that much, I've put it slightly off to the side just for emphasis. But it goes down his chin and then it goes slightly under his neck. And the reason I put a wee bit more paint on some than the others is just to make them a wee bit thicker. Because some cuts are quite thick, whereas others are quite thin. And I might drag a wee bit of out to make it give it a wee bit of irritation looking, with that stupid laptop keeps locking itself. So what's next? I would say the only thing's next, so the next bit's quite simple. You just take your thinnest brush, dip it in the black, and then again you can follow the reference photo or you can choose your own pattern. You need to draw your stitches on, because obviously in Bride of Chucky, I hate that film, it was horrendous. When Tiffany found him, she stitched them back together. So I've noticed there's not stitches on every single cut, and I've noticed I've actually left some cuts out, so I'll do those in a minute. There's not stitches on every single cut, and at the same time there's not stitches on, say, one cut. There may be loads of stitches, and others there may be one or two. So the best thing to do is just You just drag it on very slightly, just a wee short distance. Or alternatively, you could use real thread. You could, you know, spare gum it on to, if you want it to look lifelike. But then it's up to you. Just do whatever works for you. So there's all the stitches on, and then finally I'm gonna have to go and wash my brush, but finally I'm gonna use some staples. And what you can do is, to make this look more realistic, you could get some staples, cut the bottoms off, obviously safety reasons, and then spirit gun them onto the areas you want. It'll just make it look more realistic. I'm not gonna do that, one, because I think it's a bit dangerous, and two, I've no staples. So I'm just gonna go and wash this brush. As you can see, it's filthy. I'm just gonna wash it, and then we'll finally get to use the silver one, and then I'll try and think of anything else to do to complete the course with it. But if I find my outfit, I might put it on, you never know. I'll see you in a minute. So, I've got most of it off. The red wouldn't come off, but I think it was already on anyway. So there's that. I love... Oh, the silver looks hideous, but... Oh, darn it, where'd that go? Sorry, guys, I knocked the camera there. Let's try and fix it. I say I knocked the camera, it's my phone I'm filming on, because my iPad's dead, and so is my video camera. So, why do I get the feeling this isn't the silver? It's just a bit of plastic. But yeah, what I'm going to do is, once I get the reference photo back up, I'm just going to do a big, you can use just like a specialist, just big thick lines in areas that he has staples, or again, wherever you want. And that's it. You will notice the staples came out pink. It's because since there was still a wee bit of red left on my brush, and I couldn't get it off, so it's come out a wee pink. But generally that's it. I'm actually pretty happy with how that looks. It looks way better than the last time. So I'll just zoom in there so you can see better. You can see. If there was latex, obviously it would look a lot better. But I have to admit, this one here, I'm pretty happy with. I'm actually really happy with. But like I said, latex would obviously make it look better. But right now I'm just gonna go and pop my costume on. If I can find it. If I can't find it, we'll see what happens. But just because I feel like I should let you see what it looks like with the cosplay. Dear me, it's been a while since I last wore this. But here you are. Hasn't taken any of the makeup off, has it? That's what I was worried about. I'm gonna lift my camera up here just so you can see a bit better. Whoops. There you are. And then just take this out. Well, my hair's good enough. Looks a bit crazy. And as you know, it says good guys. Don't know if you can see that. I think Chucky, let's be honest guys, Chucky's not a good guy. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm pretty happy actually with how this went. Would have loved to have used latex, but unfortunately it's not really an option. But yeah, but quick tip just before I go. If you do feel the need to use latex, which could make it look a lot better. Sorry, one of my stitches is covered there. Just put it on in the areas you want. Don't put it around your eye, but put it just in the areas you want. So say just do about 7 or 8 layers here, then cut into it. You'll know why I'm not doing it now. And then, you know, just fill it in with your paints and do that. It'll just make it look a wee bit more 3D. And then also covering it with foundation will just even it out a little bit. And that, you know, so if you don't put it all over your face, even if you do cover it with foundation, it'll just even it out and remove any, you know, just colourings or anything like that. But yeah, that's it guys. So that's all I have to show you. I really hope you enjoyed this. And I hope I've managed to redeem myself. I don't know what the next cosplay is going to be, I'm going to be honest, I've no clue. I'm actually a wee bit broke at the moment, so I'm still trying to finish my Sweeney Todd cosplay. Those of you who follow me on Twitter, possibly Instagram as well, was it on Instagram? I can't think. Well, I've seen the photo of the jacket that came lately, I actually admit I was over the moon. But, oh, face paint on my finger. But yeah, once that's complete, then I'll probably do the next cosplay. That's what I'm actually prioritising that right now, because I only have one more thing to get. So I really want to put that as priority. But I got a lot of requests for some top 10 lists. I posted on Facebook. I went on to the fandom group and asked, guys, what sort of top 10 lists should I do? Because most of you know I do top 10 lists. Got quite a few requests. I hope I screenshotted them, because if I didn't, I'm in trouble. And I know some of you subscribed to me, so I'm very sorry if I've lost them. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So until next time, bye.